All right, folks. Well, a little update on the KX125, the 99. This is the issue. I know I haven't done a video on it for a while. After I bolted up the Electron, it ran like shit, and I just kind of gave up on it. Started focusing more on other projects around the house. But I went to go ride today in the 426. I bought a new set of rims and axles. Not new, but used. And yeah, I'm running into spacer issues. That's a whole other video of what you can run into when you buy used rims. So stay tuned for that. But here's my reed cage out of the 125. And look at that. I don't know if you can see that. See all that gap? So that's a good sign that your reed valves are completely gone. There's nothing. They do not function as designed anymore. They are letting air go back through the other way in the intake plane, and they are not atomizing fuel going that way. So one of the symptoms of this that you're going to notice is you're going to see hard-to-start issues, plug fouling, and excessive rich mixture. No matter what you do with the carburetor, it's always going to act like it's bogging out and loading up. And that's how you fix this. Now, for me, you can just replace the reeds, and if you're on a budget, I recommend doing that. Some guys are going to tell you can flip these around and get more life out of them. Don't listen to them. That's really retarded. These things are cheap, and if you're taking the time to tear this out, because I'm telling you right now, you flip them around, you're going to be doing this again in a few rides, and it's completely stupid. Just buy a new set of reeds. Now, me, I went with the entire new reed cage with a whole different setup here from V-Force. These are V-Force 3s. They don't make any newer version of it for this year, make and model of the bike. But the fact that these are still available and this was on sale, I figured, what the fuck? I had one on my YZ250 back in the day, and boy, did it make a big difference having the whole reed set up. So the drawback to going with the aftermarket reed cage is the factory intake has these prong or rubber venturis that stick out here. And they're encased in rubber, but as you can see here, they definitely have a metal core to them. So I had to use a cutoff wheel, and it's not my cleanest work, okay, I get it. But none of the mating surfaces as far as where air can get past it, those aren't goobered up, so we're good on that. But yeah, you will have to cut the factory manifold for the 125. I don't know about the 250, but at least for the 99 KX125, when you run the V-Force reeds, you are going to have to modify the intake. This is a brand new intake. The old one out there was cracked. So there were numerous things that I started noticing when I just could not get this thing to run right. And I went back to the basics instead of blaming the carburetor. Look at things past it. Because when you change carburetors and nothing changes, generally there's something else going on. So I should have looked at this first, but I did get a hell of a deal on the Electron carburetor. And instead of writing a scathing review on their website or giving a shitty video review, I decided to check this out first and see. And so yeah, lo and behold, these are no good. So yeah, that will cause your bike to run like absolute dog shit, and if it runs at all. Most of the time when they're this bad, you can't even get them started, which is pretty much the situation I was running into. It would roll start. I mean, you could pop start it, but then it'd foul the plug in like fucking a minute and a half of running. So anyways, next video we'll have loaded up on the bike, and or loaded up, we'll have it installed on the bike, and pretty much see how it runs, and maybe I'll be able to properly tune that Electron carburetor. They don't need much tuning, which is really cool. Unfortunately, since I've been dicking with it and having this as the real problem, I'm gonna have to fucking start from scratch. So I'll do a video on how to tune the carb if it's too far out of whack and all that shit. There's a very limited adjustment with the Electron carburetors before you have to switch out the eddy needle on it to give you a different air fuel mixture. But hopefully we're still within those parameters. It came off of a KDX 200. This is a 125, shouldn't be that big of a difference. I might have to lean it out just a hair, but I don't think it's a big enough CC displacement where I need to get new hardware for the Electron itself. So anyways, like, share, subscribe, get you a set of these. I'm not sponsored by V-Force or whoever the fuck this Moto Tarsanarani, whatever. I'm not sponsored by them, but I will back their shit. I've had good results with every single one of the bikes I've put these on. Some mine, some customers and whatnot. So yeah, either way, Like, share, subscribe, give me a big thumbs up if you're new to the channel. Click that notification bell to get updated with new videos and content. I don't release it often, so I won't be blowing up your notification box. So, again, thank you for tuning in. If you have any comments, post or questions, go ahead and post them down below. YouTube's been really shitty about notifying me when people make comments on my videos, so I'm trying really hard to go back and, I mean, there's ones that, like, it flags for some stupid fucking reason, and it's not even offensive or anything like that. I don't know. It's a whole cluster. So be patient with me. Just leave your question down below. If you can find someone else to answer your question sooner, by all means, please exercise that. But anyways, thanks again, guys. See ya.